What is going on, guys? In this video, I will show you how to sterilize tissue culture vessels using UV light. I'm going to start by making 1 liter of 0.5 ml media. It is 0.5 ml media with 25 grams of sucrose, 1 milliliter per liter of BA, 0.1 milliliters per liter of NAA, 1 milliliter per liter of BPM, and 3 grams of Gellan gum. This is the media I normally use in my aquatic and carnivorous plants. I didn't change anything. The only difference is that I'm going to add the media to this 1 liter glass flask. Sterilize the media in the flask and then pour the media into the non-sterile vessels. After that, I will use a UV light to sterilize the vessels. Here is the UV light. It is a 30 watts UVC germicidal lamp and provides a highly effective UVC irradiance of 254 nanometers. My $40 lamina flow hood already had one installed, but it was broken. So now we can say that this is a $60 lamina flow hood instead. When working with UV light, please be very careful and protect your eyes. These are professional OD6 Plus UV safety glasses. They are rated for 190 to 550 nanometers and 800 to 1700 nanometers wavelength. I can barely tell the light is on with these glasses. They are a bit expensive, but they are a must if working with UV light. Don't try to use regular sunglasses for this. Even if they say UV protect, they mean UV from the sun. The pressure cooker is on and it is time to pour the media. I'm going to use deli containers, but you can use any type of vessel. Many professional labs make media this way. They make the media in 1 liter flask, then pour it inside the lamina flow hood into sterile petri dishes or magenta boxes, baby food jars, etc. They buy sterile petri dishes for about 25 cents each, which can get expensive very quickly, or autoclave their vessels using a dry cycle. So they basically got the expensive way of buying sterile petri dishes or use the autoclave twice to make media, which in my opinion is not very efficient. This method with UV light saves time because you don't have to sterilize the vessels and the media separately. It also saves money because you can use cheaper 10-cent deli containers, 4-cent portion cups, or reuse glass flasks. After 20 minutes under the UV light, the flask and the media should be completely sterile. 2 weeks after the UV sterilization, the media did not get contaminated and I think it is safe to use for tissue culture. The media does have PPM, which is also very helpful. However, because of the PPM, the contamination can be delayed by many weeks. For that reason, I'm only using 5 out of the 10 deli containers. If any non-used deli containers get contaminated in the next few weeks, then the UV light may not have worked. I do have high hopes for the UV light, and I will use it even if I have an increase in contamination. Let's say even if the contamination rate goes up by 10%, it saves me close to 60 to 80% of time. If I sterilize the media and the vessels together in the pressure cooker, I can do 2 liters of media at a time. However, I can fit 9 1-liter bottles in the pressure cooker. With that being said, I'm only going to use UV sterilized vessels for my personal tissue culture. Any other media and vessels used for future experiments on this channel will be properly sterilized using the pressure cooker. I will let you know if the UV light works. I think I'm going to start making monthly updates on what is going on in the lab, each experiment, and the tissue culture plants. Until then, please subscribe to the channel and visit plantcelltechnology.com.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching the video. If you're enjoying these tissue culture videos, be sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you're interested in conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantcelltechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use the code FP10 for 10% off your first purchase.